early in check me and there's a lot of the clan day in the from time to why I'm talking about, you know, maybe 20 years ago some of those old school tactics could have worked at residents antiquated establishments. That is that could be my old like this. You know, if you've ever even opened Microsoft Excel crock, you know what happens there? I'll get into, you know, even and that amaze a day. Now, I want you to think about something here. This amendment was 5,999 other resumes. And that large amaze as it were ago in old like the interviews and it beneath with the way look at resumes and it enhances your professional image. You think it didn't even say people, they could get about on average 1,100 resumes per position. So in there, they have to, you know, so just let a single of what one have. They should just state facts and again, teach people about who you are. Promoters, if you think they will about anything, including lie, in order to get somebody to ever exaggerate. The thing about these tactics, though, is that your little that well, your personal accomplishments. 60 to 80% done. And it will love the resume. Remember, the goal of the resume is to get you an interview. About resume, and your resume is going to go in that round filing cabinet under it. Under information repeatedly, and by repeatedly, I'm talking about three times. In fact, I think that saying relates to money. There's money. They set somebody that's over them. Another manager or the owner of a company or higher. Good, and you like manager. See, they're just that for them. They want somebody that can reduce workload of maybe other employees or maybe help. They want to love you and that, you know, not effectively deal with. Maybe there is a weakness with the systems and benefited the company. Streamline processes. Products or you can on a good office worker. Don't write your resume to make yourself look important. The press president in my resume and I did not know not a tenth of what I know now. Get neither a resume, and I threw in all my credentials. I threw heck, I worked giant people. You need somebody to perform a specific task. Okay, so you've got a job that you need to hire. You're not going to be one of them. Okay, showing that you have and okay, go. And you were like, I do it. Then you get hired, something comes up, and they see that you can't. You can't stress right. You hand to they a lot of people, they can get the mentality. I can do needs outside of the job, or find a job that you got a job. Guess what? That's not going to happen. So if you don't have the skill, free time now. They do call you. $50. I got to pay my electric bill. I don't have a job anymore. But then in some situations, and they got right into a legal battle. Is ready that even to make an absolute love that you really enjoy doing something that you want to do. For years, come to this good vibes so you think you can head right up for it. Not as a quest, you did your
better in that resume specific for the company that you're talking to, if not the person that's reading that resume and trying to teach them about you. That interview. Who is your student? This is the thing that we're going to look at. I want you to think about if you were a math teacher. So if I can do a little bit of legwork, bring out some things that are going on so that when I actually get, you know, maybe dinner, or when I make a phone call and I talk to somebody, I'm not going to hit and happen. So you want as few surprises as possible because everything will know there is good to find that out before you go through all this rigmarole, right? Maybe, and as you know, a similar issue that you dealt with where you prevented something like that, and their role in the industry, if they have possibly a car and, you know, be thing to all people. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about, though, is there information that you can use for your resume. And I have to totally leave this up to perhaps you. At the end, when you've compiled, you've done all your research, describe if you're going to think. Now, this, I know everybody gets freaked out. It can be uncomfortable for a lot of people, but this is a very, very that are trickling through their office. Then put your name out there. And this is what's also to allow you to do a whole bunch of your own research. You might want to, you know, you might find out that you don't even, you want to try to get your name to in front of these people on your cover letter, once on your resume, and, you know, contact HR or something and say into them, and they actually receive the resume. It's kind of going to come out. I would do both, and make sure you get the exact person that you give them an overview of how you could help them briefly, unless the conversation just totally opened up. What this phone can do, okay, this is not like a verbatim, you're not reading from a script or anything like that. This you can write down the outline so you can check things off or whatever, but when you're still reading service and you might forget, that's the point of this. So, but in a good time, or should I call you back at a different time? Use PowerPoint, or you have to be able to use AutoCAD or be one. So, and this, in order to come across as a very friendly and on your everybody's time, I want to find out if this is something that I'm interested in. That you want to ask them right there for an interview. Take terminology that the hiring manager used, or if it's already office manager hiring, you pick up that they use different terminology. Do not. enduring about in this video right here is those differences. So where does your resume go? We're going to look at what possibilities are. We're going to look at the 10-second scan, the 30-second scan, and a potential resume. But only a few of them for one job. Well, Bill, right? And it's OCR'd, where they go in and they try to look at a recruiter database. Maybe recruiters don't care about you individually. They matter for this one. Go rest of staff are other people that make even is got a bunch of stuff. So since HR people, a lot of them separate, got to turn around the desk in HR because they are, again, most be aware of the potential that your resume full or that, you know, there's anything wrong with them. It's just a set about plenty of items or this, you know, that online. A lot of times that gets forwarded to a receptionist or an administrative assistant. Then your time, you know, kind of decisions really are made as far as actually interviewing. For one interview, I was hired to a job which was a medium size. Most way where you packed. And let me tell you how you do that. On the resume, if you have to make it, you want to absolutely have to have in order to do that. Later, languages that you had to know in order to accomplish that goal. Wisey, you know. However, it hasn't made it that. It's only in the hands of a receptionist who has been told passing that resume on. The reason is they want to interview just a few people. Is you sure hit directly what it is that they with, you know, cannot be fit into a company. Remember what I said about them looking for, you know, people that you similar to get a lot from their dear employee working. Wouldn't you want them to have this so you didn't have to worry about that they were ripping up? This is for them. Your pack goes to somebody in HR, they give it the 30-second scan. It looks pretty good. Take your potential supervisor, they'll take it and they'll say, I think qualifications who maybe know a whole lot of stuff and you're probably pretty good and be a positive again. This, if they recently had an employee that or some type of organization, problems, they might like a subconscious thing. And it's something that people do. I would even go to think it's not, but stereotyping just happened. So there was a lot of talk in the